Hello friends, I am Pratima. I welcome you all to this video. Children can play cards and learn mathematics. So in this video, I want to share some ideas how can children play cards and learn mathematics through playing. You must have observed that they feel very excited when they watch others playing cards. This excitement and curiosity can be used to develop interest in numbers. One or more deck of playing cards is needed for it, nothing else, only they need your supervision. We can teach basic mathematics skills through playing cards. How to do? It's very easy. What type of game they will play? That is also easy. These are the suggested card games for children. They will match the shapes, they will do counting, they will making numbers, addition, multiplication, and most importantly, they will learn about the fractions, which is taught in class 7th and 6th grade. The students will learn better while playing cards. So let us proceed. First is matching shapes. If children are between age group 3 to 5 years, can play this game. The procedure is divide the cards equally among the players. Players may be 2 or more than 2, but I am discussing about only 2 players. 2 players have equal number of cards distributed, but the face of cards will not be shown, it will be down. 2 players have equal number of cards distributed, but the face of cards will not be shown, it will be down. Game starts. First player will pick the cards on the top of his deck and put on the floor, showing the face of the card now. The second player will pick his card or top card of his deck and put on the floor, showing the face of the card. If the second player's card matches with category of first one, for example, diamond, diamond, or hearts, hearts of the first player, then second player will take both the cards and keep at the bottom of his deck. If it does not match, then again the first player will show one card from his deck. If it matches with the second player's card, then first player will have the cards they are put on the floor. It will continue till the card matches with the previous one. This game ends when one of the player loses all the cards. The player having all the cards is the winner now. Next is number maker game. As we are making numbers, the face cards are not included in this game, and S's are counted as number 1. They will be included. So we have numbers from 1 to 10. Players may be 2, may be 3, may be 4, but I am saying the procedure for 2 players. Step 1, 2 or 3 cards will be distributed to each of the players. From deck of cards, give 2 cards to each of the players or let them take but without seeing the number. Don't show them the numbers. So it will be, the face will be down and it will be distributed, 2 cards will be distributed. They will make a number out of these 2 cards and they will write the possible numbers. So there will be 2 numbers. Again, from these 2 numbers, they will find out which one is greater. The players will now announce their highest number. Numbers of the 2 players will be compared again. The player whose number will be greatest, he or she will be the winner, and he or she will be all the 4 cards distributed in the first turn. Again, each player will be given 2 cards or they will take themselves without seeing the face of the cards and repeat the same procedure till the cards in the deck ends. So it will continue till the cards in the pack ends. Now each will count the number of cards. The player having maximum number of cards will be the winner. Here, please note this. If children are of age group 6 to 8, we can give 3 to 4 cards together so that they can frame the number 3 digits number, 4 digits number, and if the number of players are more, we can use 2 pack of cards so that it will be longer. Also note that the children learn here place value, comparing the numbers. Next is addition of numbers. Here, 2 or 3 cards will be given to each of the player. They will add the numbers of the cards and find whose sum is greatest. He or she will be take all the cards distributed in the turn. Again, 3 to 4 cards will be distributed. Again, they will frame the, add them and say the highest. This will repeat till the cards are finished. Procedure will be repeated. The owner of maximum cards is the winner now. Please note, each player may be given 2, 3, 4 or even 5 number of cards depending upon the age group. They can add 5 numbers. When the winner will claim the cards, every player will compare their own cards, own numbers with others, and will verify whether the person is announcing correct or not. They will learn addition very perfectly. Next game is multiplication of numbers. The procedure is same as discussed in addition. Children will be distributed the cards and they will multiply the number of the cards. The player having the highest product will take all the cards distributed in the tun. During the game, situation may arise. Both the players have the same or highest points. Then the players will share the cards among themselves. Next is a special game, card game for making fractions. The children of grade 6 to 7 can play this game to learn and practice fractions. Each player will be given two cards. He or she will arrange it to make a fraction as shown in the figure with a pencil or with a pen. Now, each player will arrange the cards to get bigger fraction. Which one will be numerator and which one will be denominator, so that it will be a maximum. Then each will announce their fraction. He or she, whoever will have the greater fraction value, will take all the four cards. So again, without seeing the face, they will be given two more cards each and make another fraction. The game will continue till the cards are finished. Whoever has the maximum number of cards will be the winner. If anybody cannot calculate or frame the fraction, then the friends can help, because in every game there are some supporters and viewers. Note, please note that this is a wonderful game, even can be practiced in the class, because more people will be there, more fraction can be made and children can learn more. Students learn numerator, denominator, mixed fraction, comparing the fraction very quickly by this game. I have a wonderful experience in the class with this game. Students learn out of the excitement. Some more games can be planned. Finding who is the lowest sum, lowest product is also a game. Let us see what are other benefits of the engagement with the cards. The students will be away from TV and computer and mobiles. Computational skills will improve. They will develop different life skills such as conflict management, empathy, sharing, and tolerating each other. Learning activity will be pleasurable. Without knowing that they are learning, they learn. For sustained and active engagement of each child, learning through game is very much necessary. If you have some new idea, you are welcome to mention in the comment box so that it can be shared with others.